Mr. President, sir, this Constituent Assembly declares its firm and solemn resolve to proclaim India as an independent sovereign republic and to draw up for her future governance a constitution wherein the territories will be governed by the country.
In substance, my amendment proposes we postpone passing this resolution to a later stage to enable the Muslim League and the Indian states to participate, if they choose so, in the deliberations of the assembly.
Now, I call upon Dr. Ambedkar to take the floor.
Mr. Chairman, I am indeed very grateful to you for having called me to speak on this resolution. I know today we are divided politically, socially and economically. We are a group of warring camps, and I may even go to the extent of confessing that I am probably one of the leaders of such a camp. But sir, with all this, I am quite convinced that nothing in the world will prevent this country from becoming one. I have no hesitation in saying that, notwithstanding the agitation of the Muslim League for the partition of India, someday enough light will dawn upon them and they too will begin to think that a united India is better even for them. It seems you are firm on your stand on Pakistan.
Well, Dr. Ambedkar, in your own words and thoughts on Pakistan, you have said that Hindus think that Pakistan is a dream of Muslims, but Muslims know that Pakistan is a reality.
No, Mr. Jinnah. I'm against your two-nation theory. We should fight for the rights of the minorities staying on in this country.
Well, that stage seems to have gone. Now Pakistan is going to be a reality.
Yes, history has put this responsibility on us. I suppose I shall have to carry this blood on my conscience when I die. Well, to business then. Do you know the reason why I requested you to come here? I would like you to be a part of the national government of Free India. Do you accept?
It depends. What portfolio?
Law.
Will there be enough work?
Plenty. Don't worry. A lot of new measures are to be legislated.
Yes. The Hindu Code Bill is still pending, isn't it?
Well, we are determined to clear it fast. I'm very glad. We shall be working together.
Dear Bhaura, India is an independent country today. But will she maintain her independence? Will the many political parties with diverse and opposing political creeds place India above their own castes and creeds? We must be determined to defend our independence to the last drop of our blood.
Mr. President, sir, I introduce the draft constitution settled by the drafting committee and move that it be taken into consideration.
Mr. President, sir, I am one of those in the house who are aware of the amount of work and enthusiasm that Dr. Ambedkar has brought to bear on the work of drafting this constitution. The house is perhaps aware that of the 7 members nominated by you, one had resigned and was not replaced, one was away in America and his place was not filled up, and another person was engaged in his state affairs, and there was a void to that extent. One or two people were far away from Delhi, and perhaps reasons of health did not permit them to attend. So it happened ultimately that the burden of drafting this constitution fell on Dr. Ambedkar. and I have no doubt we are grateful to him.
The credit that is given to me does not belong to me. It belongs partly to Sir B.N. Rao, the constitutional advisor to the Constituent Assembly, who prepared a rough draft of the Constitution for the consideration of the Drafting Committee. A part of the credit must go to the members of the Drafting Committee also. I shall not enter into the merits of the Constitution because I feel, however good a Constitution may be, it is sure to turn out bad because those who are called to work it happen to be a bad lot. However bad a Constitution may be, it may turn out to be good if those who are called to work upon it happen to be a good lot. It is therefore futile to pass any judgment upon the Constitution without reference to the part which the people and their parties are likely to play. Thank you.
And sitting in this chair and watching the procedures from day to day, I have realized what no one else could have, with what rare zeal and devotion the members of the drafting committee and especially its chairman, Dr. Ambedkar, irrespective of his indifferent health, have worked.
In spite of factual objections,